there, welcome back to Beauty Bee, and welcome to a check-in video for the chopping block video that I filmed maybe about 2 weeks ago. So I have my little box of chopping block items. We're going to go through them today, starting with one that I didn't even bother to try. This is from Dickinson's. It is their original Witch Hazel Pore Perfecting Toner. And I just decided, I don't care. I don't want to try this out. I just don't want this. So I'm going to pass it along. It's all sealed up. It hasn't been opened. I'm sure that I have a family member who will get more use out of this than I would, and will probably enjoy that use more than I would have enjoyed it. So that's out of the way. Now let's get to the things that I actually did try. So first up, we have this Black Opal Highlighting Stick. This is the shade Nude Glow. Now clearly, this is not a highlighter on me. It is very brown. And when I first got this, I thought that maybe it could be a decent cream bronzer on me, or maybe a cream blush. But, I mean, it is a highlighter. It is intended to be a highlighter, and it just doesn't perform the way that I would want a cream blush or bronzer to perform on me. It doesn't have quite enough pigment to it, and when it does sheer out, it's just not quite the right color to be either a bronzer or a blush. It almost looks just wrong on me. I don't know. I don't know quite what is wrong with this color to make it not jive with my skin, but it just doesn't. The formula on this is actually quite nice. It's kind of a cream to powder stick, but yep, not for me. So unfortunately, I did think that this was going to work for me, so I can't really pass this along to anyone. There's no one in my life who this shade would work for that I would also feel comfortable passing used makeup to. So that's gonna have to go in the garbage, unfortunately. Let's see. Next up is the last item that will be just straight up decluttered. This is from e.l.f. and it is their putty eye primer. Now this is a white eye primer. It is very thick. I think, looking back, that I definitely got this on sale on the e.l.f. website, so I wonder if it was already starting to dry out by the time I got it, and it definitely hasn't gotten better with time. So here's what this looks like. It is a white eye primer, and it does, I think, give some shadows just a little bit of extra pop, and I can definitely see how this could be worth messing with if you had a deeper skin tone than I do. The thing is, I have a pretty light canvas to work on anyway. You know, adding the white does lighten things up a bit, but not a whole lot. Pastels generally show up on me in eyeshadow form, even if they aren't good formulas, so yeah, I'm just not impressed with how much this adds to my eye look, and it's just not a pleasant product to use. So this is getting decluttered. Next up, we have my little set of single shadows. Most of these are Wet n Wild shades that I've repressed. In fact, I'm pretty sure all of the ones that I know the provenance of are eyeshadow shades from Wet n Wild that were in that 32 or 28 pan palette that I had from them and have repressed into these magnetic pans. And I am going to be getting rid of most of these. I think you can tell there's definitely a color scheme with these shades, and I don't wear a whole lot of super warm eyeshadows. I don't feel that orange is a great color for me, so it's not a shade I tend to wear very often. I have these kind of basic bronzes several times over other places in my collection. These two oranges are just not my shade, not something that I'm ever going to reach for very often. And there are actually two shades that I'm going to be keeping out of this palette, but everything else will be leaving. First up, we have this lightest shade, and it's not that this is a particularly unique shade to my collection or anything like that. I just really don't have a whole lot left, and I would like the satisfaction of panning this. Let's see. Where have I not swatched things? I guess it doesn't really matter. I can swatch over the e.l.f. It is not a very impressive shade. It's not something that I'm in love with, but I just want to pan it. That's it. And then the other shade that I will be keeping is this deepest shade in the palette. It's like a very deep reddish brown. And I have shades that look kind of like this in my collection. I have some in the Wet n Wild Cherry Crush palette that look like they could be pretty similar, though everything in that palette is like wham, bam, pigment, and this is not. And I actually really like that about this. This is the kind of shade that I would see being very workable and very easy to add to the outer corner just to deepen things up a little bit. It's buildable, which I prefer over straight pigment. Easy to blend. Just overall, I think this is a shade that I might actually get some use out of versus the other shades that I have here, which I just don't think I'm super likely to use. I don't use these kinds of oranges and bronzes all that often anyway, and then compound that with the fact that these are just not very attractive. I repress these. I am not very good at repressing. It's something that I would like to get better at, but at the same time, I don't really want to sacrifice a bunch of products that I actually like to my quest to become a better repressor. So, yeah, I'm not going to use the ugly pans over prettier pans that I have other places in my collection. So, these seven shades are going to go, and I think I will actually, probably in a couple more weeks, likely do another chopping block video, really going through my single shadows again, especially these other repressed Wet n Wild ones. I feel like there are definitely some in there that haven't been touched in a very long time and might not need to take up space in my collection anymore. But anyway, that is a topic for another video. For this video, let's move on to a brush. This is a big ol' fan brush from Bella Beauty or Bea Beauty. This is like a really inexpensive brush that I got at Goodwill, actually. Not used, but I did buy it at Goodwill about a year ago, and I just wanted to show you the purpose that I have found for this brush, because I realized quite early on that it's not good for my face. It's just, I mean, that's a quarter of my face right there. However, I have been quite enjoying these off-the-shoulder tops, and let me show you. Let's put a little bit of bronzer, a little bit of highlight on this brush. Is just perfect size for this purpose. I love how it makes my skin look. Well, the product is what's making my skin look good, but this is a nice, easy way to apply. And just, I think that it's just really convenient. I'd kind of forgotten that this was how I'd used this brush in the past. Let's just add a little more. Okay. I was just in a very narrow way thinking of this as a face brush when there's nothing stopping me from using it other places on my body, and I'm pretty sure that I've used this many, many times on my shoulders and just forgotten about it. But this is going to be staying. I really like this. I find it quite useful. And just overall, I'm really happy that I did this project, even if it was just to find that brush and find a purpose for that brush again. And then the last item in this project is this Wet n Wild Cloud Pout Liquid Lipstick. I am wearing this today, actually. It's the only lip product that I'm wearing today. Any shine that I have on my lips right now is because I was wearing some lip balm first thing this morning and didn't bother to wipe it off before I applied, though I don't think there was a whole lot left. Additionally, I have been sipping on some Diet Coke since I applied this. But I think that this color works really, really well with the outfit I'm wearing today. Do I have a mirror anywhere? No, that would be way too convenient. Let me apply just a little bit more. It is not a shade that I think I will want to wear every day, though I do think that I can continue to play around with this, adjusting it a little bit using glosses and lip liners and even other liquid lipsticks to get shades that might be a little bit more everyday friendly for me. However, I think that like with this outfit, with this entire look, it works really well. I'm quite happy with it. Maybe if I find a couple of things that are just perfect to mix this with, it might become something that I reach for on a weekly basis, but even just as is, I mean, I clearly have at least one outfit that this works really well with. I'm quite happy with my look today, and it's something that I at least see myself using every once in a while. So, the results of this little chopping block project are that I will be decluttering an eye primer, a bronzer stick, highlight stick, 7 eyeshadows, as well as this toner. I will be keeping 2 eyeshadows, the lipstick, and the brush. So overall, I think this was very successful. I found a new favorite. I found, if not a new favorite, then at least a combination of outfit and lip color that I feel really works nicely. And I managed to narrow down my single shadow collection a little bit. We're just calling this one a massive success. I'm very happy with how this turned out. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please let me know if you have been doing a similar chopping block project, how that has been coming for you. Have you been doing a little bit more decluttering? I would be very interested to hear about that. Thanks again. Please consider liking and subscribing if you enjoyed, and I hope that I will see you all next time. Bye!